We sweep on now to Political Biography of the Year, and the judges in this category were these people.
Labour MP Chris Bryant, Strictly star Anne Widdecombe, and Rob Wilson, Conservative MP for Reading East.
Yes, and here to present the award for Political Biography of the Year, please welcome the thinking man's Russell Grant. It is indeed Anne Widdecombe.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to be here, and particularly to be presenting this award for a political biography. I was always very dubious about political biography ever since I read Giles Brandreth's autobiography. It wasn't so much what was written in the book, it was what he said as he went round promoting the book. And he told a story which is entirely fictional. That when he was at university, there were three rooms all next to each other in a ladies' college. And in the first room was his wife, Michelle. And in the second room was Edwina Curry. And in the third room was Mary Archer. And in the fourth room was Anne Widdecombe. And he said he was so glad he stopped at the first room. So am I glad that he stopped at the first room. If I can just be a little bit serious for a moment about political biography, it is a tremendously important genre. Because if it's well done, if it isn't just an exercise in justification, self-justification, if it isn't just an endless regurgitation of every clause of every bill that the politician may have been involved in, then what it can do is actually make politics accessible and intelligible as well as exciting to people who are not part of the Westminster Village. People, of course, who are part of the Westminster Village are not all practicing politicians, and the nominees, which I'm going to be giving you in a moment, are not, as you will note, all simply ex-politicians. And those nominees are...
The Burden of Power by Alastair Campbell, published by Hutchinson. Nancy by Adrian Fort, published by Jonathan Cape. Inside the Centre by Ray Monk, published by Jonathan Cape. A Kick Against the Pricks by David Norris, published by Transworld Ireland. Muckraker by W. Sidney Robinson, published by the Robson Press. Last Man Standing by Jack Straw, published by Macmillan. Events, Dear Boy, Events by Ruth Winston, published by Profile Books.
And the winner is W. Sidney Robinson, Muckraker.
I can honestly say that this is a huge surprise and an honour, and it was also a great honour to have written a book about a tabloid newspaper editor who had a conscience and conviction in what he did, that although he sometimes went too far in crusading for justice, it's something that everyone working in the media today could take something from his life to try to change the world in a very positive way. So thank you very much to everyone involved and to my agent, James Wills, who's been very supportive. Thank you to the judges. Thank you to Lord Dashcroft. Thank you.
Well done. Beautifully judged speech. And you know, it's just 15% of the address given to the agent. Perfect. Beautifully done. And thank you. I've known, Anne and I have known each other, it must be said, since we were teenagers. The story she told there, I'm afraid, is true. I'll tell one other true story about Anne. When she was a Home Office Minister, we went together on a visit. We went together on a visit by train, and I was getting onto the train. She saw me going off to the first class compartment. She said, where are you going? I said, I'm going to the first class. She said, no, you're not. You're sitting here with me. The taxpayer is paying for your ticket. You're sitting here with me. And we sat in the steerage compartment. She had a ministerial box. She worked away. And from that day onwards, actually, at the taxpayer's expense, I never traveled first class. She never did. She is a person of true integrity. Well done, Anne. Marvelous.